As many WYCN TV 13 viewers already know and appreciate, Kalcha has enjoyed a delightful relationship with Electric Earth Concerts, New Hampshire's premier classical music series, which, under the incomparable direction of Laura Gilbert and Jonathan Bagg, continues to bring an uncanny collection of musicians and soloists abuzz on the international marquee to the Monadnock Valley. Tonight's tour de force, Ira, arranged by Osvaldo Guliav and performed in Keene's Ahavas Akim Synagogue, is no exception. Yours truly caught up with Laura at her New York City home to set the stage for an unforgettable musical experience.
Ira, the concert that I came to New York to talk to you about, oh my gosh, our audience is, as of yet, unbeknownst to most of them, I'm pretty sure I can say, what are they in for?
Oh my goodness. Well, Osvaldo Guliav wrote this piece as a kind of an olive branch. He's an Argentinian Jew whose family, generations ago, came to South America from Europe. And he holds on to a very strong feeling about his ethnicity, both as a Jew and as somebody who is part of a Latino culture. So he was inspired in so many different ways when he wrote this. And so I think actually the thing that the audience is in for is just a beautiful, inspirational work, a work that comes from a composer's heart for many, many reasons. But what one takes away from it, I think that we're just unprepared for, and you'll see, is this beautiful message about the world and world music and music in general and culturalism in music. So, you know, Guliav wrote this piece.
And at a timely period in our history.
Yeah, well, you know, actually, a very timely period, but sadly, its timeliness repeats itself over so many centuries.
Right.
It's really sad. But the work is a song cycle, basically. And it's a song cycle that Mr. Guliav himself doesn't take credit for as far as the original material.
Because
all the songs are already songs. All the texts are already texts. Some of them are old, very old, ancient Sephardic texts, ancient Christian texts, Arabic texts. Some are modern texts from the Arabic, Christian, and Jewish cultures. And there's a beautiful contemporary poem in the middle of it all, which kind of is the linchpin of the piece in a way. The poem makes us understand that we're dealing with the idea of displacement, identity that's struggling to find itself because of the displacement of the people who the songs are about and who sing the songs. But it's a beautiful cycle in which he takes these old and pre-composed works and sews them together in his own personal way, using his instrumentation and using his sense of color and his sense of drama in the shape, the arc of the music, and in the building up of drama of the work.
Thank you. Oh, Thank you. Be a stream, water, to my guitar. Conquerors come, conquerors go. It's getting hard to remember my face in the mirrors. Be a memory for me so I can see what I've lost. Who am I after these paths of exodus? I own a boulder that bears my name on a tall bluff overlooking what has come to an end. 700 years escort me beyond the city walls. Time turns around in vain to save my past from a moment that gives birth to the history of my exile in others and in myself. Be a stream, water, to my guitar. Conquerors come, conquerors go. Heading south as nations decompose on the compost of change. I know who I was yesterday, but who will I be tomorrow? Under the Atlantic flag of Columbus. Be a stream to my guitar, water. Be a stream.
Oh.
First of all, here I was running a camera during this. My heart was just dancing through a lot of it, but there were times of sadness too, and it's that universal language that you don't know why, and but you could follow the words, and then when the techno music interrupted I was like, oh, this is like a new generation of music wedded to it, and it was so complete with it. I loved that dichotomy, and watching the personalities, and then being able to see the close-ups he took with his camera on his side, and the combination of so many people. And I just gotta say that the soprano was like, oh my gosh.
Alana's amazing. You know, as we were rehearsing it in the space that afternoon, I looked around at all the people playing, and I had this thought that this notion of displacement, you know, the reason that there's all the modern music is because I think Golihoff is saying, we're still struggling with that, you know? We're still in this modern age, you know, with the techno music and, you know, the dancing in the streets and everything, and the younger generation now, you know, and all of the stuff that's gone on in the Middle East with the incredible, you know, spring-like feeling of the young people rebelling and everything.
Egyptian Spring.
Yeah. You know, that there's still this huge issue of displacement and people not feeling that they are welcomed and belong within a culture. I think, is it in Wahhabibi? It's in one of them where the words are something around like that you've closed the walls of Jerusalem to us, and if you could, you would close the doors of heaven to us, but you can't. You know, this idea of an isolation and an exclusion. And I was looking around and thinking, well, there's Alana Davidson, who's the soprano. Alana's father, his name is Hazan Charles Davidson, and he's a very famous cantorial composer and cantor and cantorial teacher. And her family comes from Europe. They fled Europe before the war and came here. My family left Latvia, Russia, Germany, France, before the First World War. They fled. They were fleeing Jews. Alexander Sevastian, the accordion player, is a Russian emigre who fled Russia basically to have an opportunity to have freedom, to be a musician, express himself, move around the world, and be an artist. There are so many people. Everybody in that group has a story of displacement, and what a universal feeling it is, and that those moments of sadness in the music are moments that we can all relate to. We can all relate to that feeling of displacement. And the dancing that you're talking about, there's this incredible feeling of joy and celebration at life. Just a celebration of we're here now and this is
together.
What's going on together. You know, it's really funny because we did this performance again. This performance was a collaboration with Portland Chamber Music Festival in Portland, Maine. And that's one of the reasons that we were able to pull it off with all the rehearsal time and all the personnel.
I wonder.
Yes, but when we played it in Portland, Osvaldo Golihoff actually came to the concert.
And darn!
Yeah, I know. Well, he and the director of the Portland Chamber Music Festival have known each other for 25 years before he was anybody other than a wonderful composer and very warm, lovely man. And so their relationship goes back, and so he was very happy to come up and speak to the audience. But afterwards, we all went out together. And what Osvaldo said about the music was that he felt that its strongest characteristic was that of traveling, of moving around.
Nomadic
quality to it. And so at the dinner, I asked him after the concert, I said, you know, to me, the most obvious feature of this music is that the music it is Christian, Arabic, Jewish, and you can't tell the difference. It's all one music. And the extension of that is that we're all one people, singing this, feeling it, experiencing it, celebrating it. And you didn't say that. And he said, well, you know, yeah, that's absolutely right. He said, we all lived together, we married each other, we had children together, and we killed each other. That was his comment. And I, you know, I just thought, that's right. You know, if it were just people looking at what we're creating musically, artistically, and understanding that it's one voice expressing these feelings, one voice regardless of anything that their upbringing ethnically provided them with, then there would be a lot more harmony and peace, and we might not be experiencing a lot of what we are.
Well, let me close by saying it's been an extraordinary season for me, young as you are, and there's some extraordinary concerts left. You can go to electricearthconcerts.org for the remaining of them, the last one being November 14th. I look forward to seeing you at the rest of them. I'm Carolyn Choate. Thanks for watching this.